Alright guys, so if you guys are still choosing to train at home because you guys don't want to get out too much, then we actually have a few in-home trainings you guys can do. Now you don't need any equipment for this, it's actually all body weight. So sometimes when I think of body weight, I think, oh, it's easy. But I actually think if I were to do this whole entire workout, then I actually would be kind of like dying because I'm not used to the conditioning. So there's a lot of conditioning with it. But here's what we're gonna have for you guys. We showed you the first day. This is gonna be day number two of what we have. There's gonna be three different stations. Let me show you the first one right here. So, really simple. It's just gonna be two exercises, five sets. It's gonna be 20 lunge jumps. So if you guys take a look right here, I'm just gonna come straight down into my lunge. So I'm coming down, then right back up, come down, right back up. So that's one rep, that's two reps, that's three reps. You go all the way up to 20. Now if you wanna focus on something for this, all you need to do is you take a look at my knee. It's nice and close to the floor. You want to make sure we just don't do our step back. Otherwise, we're just stepping back, right? You're just going to come down. Knee comes close. Another thing you can take a look at is this knee. See, 90 degrees. You don't want an excessive bend in it. Okay, that might bug your knee in the long run. You can have a little bend, but just nothing excessive. That's 20 reps. Right after you finish your 20, you're going to come straight down to your V-ups. But the V-up is gonna actually be on the side so we can fire more obliques to this. So, I'm down, I come right up for the toe, and right back down. Right up for the toe, and then right back down. So what I'm actually doing here, I'm actually balancing on my butt cheek, just on one butt cheek. That way we can fire up that oblique. Okay, you balance, and you take a look at my hand. The bottom hand is gonna post on the floor. Alright, so it gives me some stability. When I come up, it stays on the floor and it just kind of slides with me. Once you finish 10 on one side, all you do is switch, rotate, and then you hit 10 on the other. So that's what we got. It's pretty straightforward, pretty simple, but it'll be a lot of conditioning. So 20 lunge jumps, every single leg counts. Then you come down to the floor, you hit your side V-ups for your obliques, 10 reps on each side. That's gonna be one round. You're gonna repeat that five times, and it should take you roughly about 10 minutes. Cool, so we finished up the first station. Now, the second station is simple too. Okay, all these exercises are actually really basic for us today. It's actually gonna be, same thing, two exercises. It's gonna be push-ups and air jacks. So when you hit your push-ups, it's just 12 reps. Look, we went over this before, but if you need to see again, you're just right there. If you take a look at how the push-up is working, I'm bringing it down towards the floor, then pushing up, just like the name is. Same thing if you want to use the knees for a little assistance. You come down, right back up, come down, right back up. When you do your push-ups, the only thing we want to be sure of is we're coming down nice and deep, okay? So to get the four-inch motion, if you have to use your knees, hit those knees. We want you to get a big stretch in your chest and your shoulders. That way you can actually fire up all the muscle that's working there. It's the same thing with your chest press if you use weights too. But you want to just get a good range of motion. You come down deep, your back is straight, and then right back up. You also want to watch out for this thing, okay? Same thing with the hips. You want to watch out for that flop or the head hitting the floor, okay? Just keep it down. Just think about your back is straight and your chest comes down towards the floor. Back is straight, chest comes down to the floor. Just think, no bending in the hips, you should be good. That's 12 reps. Once you finish your 12 reps, you're gonna go straight into air jacks. So this is a variation of a jumping jack, but you're gonna do a little hop with it as well. You take a look at my feet. My feet are actually gonna be together, and I come down for a little squat, and then when I get ready for my jumping jack, I'm gonna jump up, come out, right back. That's one, that's two, that's three, that's four. So you take a look at those legs, they come out, they come right back together. Come out, right back together. That's 20 reps. That one, I'm actually a little winded from doing those right now. Now, those two exercises, 12 push-ups, 20 air jacks, 5 sets. All right, y'all, so here's the last one, station number 3. Same thing, two exercises, I'm gonna give you X amount of reps. The focus on this one is just really getting your heart rate pumping. So, what we have, first one is gonna be skaters. You have 20 reps. So if you take a look, all I need to do is you have some space around you, and all you do is jump, opposite hand reaches for that opposite toe, jump, opposite hand reaches for that opposite toe, okay? And you're gonna focus on coming up and down, one mistake that I see with this is when we just stay down the whole time, okay? But what I wanna see us do is stay up tall, you're gonna hop, and then reach. Tall, hop,
tall hop, then reach. If you can keep your foot off the floor, try and keep that foot off the floor if you can. But if you really have to, you can go ahead and do that for balance and slowly start getting that foot off. Once you finish 20 reps, you got 20 knee taps. You come down, you're gonna be in a plank position on your hands like you're about to do a push-up. Your back is flat, your butt's not up in the air. All you have to do, just tuck those knees in, bring it out, tuck the knees in, bring it out. So if you're looking at me here, you're noticing that my butt is not excessively coming up and down. I'm keeping it down. You just bring in, right back out, in, right back out. Both of those are gonna be 20 reps. 20, 20, you have 5 rounds, and that's it. Then you completed the whole second day. You have all 3 of those stations. The whole day should take you roughly about 30, 40 minutes, and then you'll be done. So that's the first, second in-home training y'all got.